What's up, everybody? Welcome back to LA Noire. Dang it, I don't know what's been going on with the Elgato today, but it keeps giving me problems with connecting. Normally don't have an issue when I move between consoles with the HDMI, but today, it's been kind of a pain in the butt. Alright, there we go. LA Noire, we're back. I need to open up a previous LA Noire part to figure out two things. One, what part number this is, and two, part four, it looks like. Right? Part two. Okay, my camera's fine in the spot it is right now. Okay, welcome into part number four of LA Noire. We have three cases left on the, we have three cases left on the... three cases left on the homicide desk. Boy, I put my headphones on and I forgot that I turned it up for the last part of the stream, and it was very loud in my ears. Three cases left in the homicide desk. This is part number four, which I believe when we're done with this, we should be about halfway there. From what I looked at, it seems like it's going to be about eight parts. So we'll go ahead and jump back in here while this is doing its thing. The white shoe slang was the last one that I completed. I'm going to pull up the true achievements. Excuse me. The true achievements walkthrough so we can get five stars on all the cases and get all the miscellaneous achievements. L A Noire. The white shoe slang. I feel like this is the one that I did a ton because there was supposed to be a car in this one that I needed. Ooh, the bus. I dropped my cord. Feels good. And then the. White shoe slaying. Alright.
Good morning, gentlemen, and what a grand morning it is, too. We have just cause for celebration. Galloway and Phelps are sending another fiend to San Quentin. A nice showy trial, and he'll be strapped down with gas seeping into his tiny reptile brain. Now.
Noise. The fresh murder. Woo!
Galloway and Phelps.
Yeah! Task is at kill him!
The address is on the hill, north downtown off Fremont Avenue.
All right.
Skipper, is the new letter genuine?
Now, boys, we all know how many imbeciles have confessed in the short case. Ray Pinker will let us know in good time.
All right.
Fine morning indeed. We keep locking them up, but the bodies keep piling up.
Yeah, California's love a fad, Phelps. As long as the bricks hold up at San Quentin, there'll always be killers in this town to send.
What a wonderful sentiment. Everybody loves a fad. This year's fad, murder. Oh, 1947 is going to be a year for murder.
California. When's it going to stop?
Maybe this isn't the one? Whip it around town.
First the letter, and now another body. Come on, you can't keep on telling me there's not a killer still out there.
You know, Phelps, all these arrests on the racket are giving you a reputation. You don't want them turning into unsolved.
Getting a vicious killer off the streets is more important than my reputation.
Really?
And besides, landing a big fat marlin is more impressive than an ocean full of minnows.
The minnows maketh the man, Phelps. You can't always hit home runs.
The manners maketh man? He's a kingsman. Whoops. Oh, remember when that movie was supposed to come out? The prequel Kingsman movie? And it got delayed about four times? What's weird is if they hadn't delayed it from their original release date, they would have put it out on time. Wild. Completely forgot that that movie was supposed to come out. Also, the movie never looked particularly good. The Kingsman franchise is something that they, like, desperately want to be, like, a thing. But they don't know what to do with it. Like,
that
we just keep making movies. I don't remember this case.
Oh,
steeling myself for what I'm about to see.
That'll just be another dead body, partner. Get used to seeing them. They're the gig when you're working homicide.
Detectives, Phelps and Galloway, homicide. Scene secure. The rest of the patrolmen are going door to door, canvassing for witnesses.
Thanks. Keep me informed.
Will do, Detective.
This looks awfully familiar.
I think that's the impression the boys from the Examiner took with them as well.
There's nothing original under the sun. Why should murder be any different?
What do we have so far?
Not much trace evidence to speak of. Storm blew in around 10 last night, and the rain washed most of it away.
And the body?
Looks like she was tipped out of an automobile from the tire tracks and superficial injuries. Strangled with a length of rope. And for my money, it's triple braid again.
Time of death?
From her temperature, maybe 2 a.m. But it was cold last night.
Usual head injuries.
Blunt force trauma. Knock him over the head, then strangle and mutilate. No message with this one.
At least she was left clothed.
I doubt very much he was concerned with her dignity.
Green silk dress is very distinctive. Any sign of her other shoe?
No. And no handbag or other personal effects.
Okay. New clue, time of death. Not a whole lot to work with on this one.
No drag marks. Killer was moving around, surveying the scene.
Who the hell was talking? That was not Cole's voice. What are you looking at? Oh, you're looking at this beer bottle, you drunken bastard?
Good to me.
Maybe there's just a little bit left. Oh, I could have just a little sip. Just a little sip for old me. Whatever his name is, I forget.
Driver and our killer are most likely one and the same.
Okay. Yep. That would make sense. Ooh, some free cash. Quiche.
Circumstantial.
There's just money on the ground here. Couldn't possibly be related to anything over here. We not, hold on. Calm down. Wait.
Appears to be a dry cleaner.
Oh, weird.
Superior Laundry Services, F1363.
That was weird. Why didn't that? Okay. So let's use this telephone. The hell is this? Okay. Looks like we got an interview here. What? Of all the cases, I've played this game a bunch, but I don't remember this at all. Up the block.
This lady thinks she has something for us.
Detective Phelps, LAPD.
I'm Mrs. Barton, Catherine Barton. I live just across the way.
Did you see anyone around here last night?
Not last night, but yesterday, early evening, I saw that awful hobo.
Do you have a description?
Tall, gaunt, horribly disfigured. I think he may have had an accident in the war. He's a very scary, angry man.
Any idea where we might find him?
One of the hobo camps around here. He's some kind of hobo leader. They all follow him around.
Thank you, ma'am. You've been a big help.
Of course. Anything I can do to help. I'd hate to think that something so ghastly could happen right here and nothing be done about it.
Oh, so close to rank 16. Come on, baby, give me rank 16. Give it to me. I want that achievement.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on Superior Laundry Services.
Just a moment. Superior Laundry Services, 1260 West 1st Street.
Can you track down reports of hobo camps in the vicinity of Signal Hill?
Just a moment, Detective. There's a large camp under the bridge on Grand between Temple and Sunset.
Thanks, ma'am.
Okay, so first we want to go to Superior Laundry Services. Oh, I'm turning the wrong way. Yeah, there you go. That's exactly... Oh my god, there's so many cars over here. Alright, hold on. Let's get in some cars, because I gotta start getting that number up. Alright, there we go. Alright, drove that one, technically. Okay. These I think I have. This is the only one I think that's like new. Maybe, but I also did stop. Were you just calm down, sir? Alright, there we go. See, that's all I needed, alright? All of these other ones have the little bump on the back, so. Nice athletics there, Cole Phelps. It's a wonder you're not in the Olympics. Alright, perfect. This is the excitement of playing LA Noire. It's going to a parking lot, driving a bunch of different cars and hoping that you get like a good chunk of them done. Because boy, driving all those cars is a big pain in the ass. Let's go! You gonna get in? Oh my god. Get in the car! Hello? Would you like to get in the car, please? Hello, sir? 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 Alright, hold on. Hold on, let me reinitiate your animation. Fucking idiot. Alright. Locations, Superior Laundry Service. Whoa!
No message.
Excuse me?
There was no message.
Where?
On the Vic. The last bodies had something written on it. This one didn't.
I'm failing to follow you.
Can't be the same guy is what I'm saying, right? Before you start trying to link this to Maldonado and all the others.
There are more factors to consider than the messages, Rusty.
This doesn't fit your pattern, Cole. End of conversation. Understand?
I don't know where I'm going. I'm very lost. Help! Can help? Superior Laundry. Here we go. Let's see.
At least the rain stopped. You can change back into those white bucks now.
What? Hello?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. We're investigating a case, and one of your laundry labels came up. F1363.
If you give me a minute, I'll go find a register and you can take a look.
Look at this fucking dynamite sweater.
You take a look for yourself. I've got clothes that need pressing.
You that man knows how to buy a sweater. There. Sweater vest? Alright, what are we looking for? F something. F363, there we go.
Mrs. T. Terrellson, 43 Emerald Street.
Oh, she just got her dress back. Alright. Is that it? Okay. That appears to be it. Okay, that's where we're going next.
I've got a feeling we're about to meet another wife killer.
You've always got that feeling, Rusty.
Yeah, and it's usually correct.
Please, please, for once, can you not let your assumptions color your detective work?
Just you wait. Nordic types show a particular disposition for this stuff.
He's like, I'm a murderer. I know exactly what to look for. I killed four of my wives. Like, okay, Rusty, you're under arrest. You're going to jail. What? Weird. 43 Emerald Street. Uh-oh. Just two little kids enjoying some television.
Hello?
I think.
Yes?
Detectives Phelps and Galloway.
Is or a radio. Home, sir?
My wife went out last night and she hasn't come home.
Oh, because she's dead.
Can you describe your wife and what she was wearing?
We were out at a friend's place, Bobby Ross's, for a party. She was kind of dolled up. She had her green silk dress, open-toed white shoes. Those are her favorite shoes.
Can we come in, Mr. Tarleton? I'm afraid we have some rather bad news.
Well, the good news is we found your wife.
Someone who can look after your children, Mr. Tarleton.
Oh, they're not watching anything. They're just staring at a chair. That's what you did in the 40s. You just stared at a chair. Last night.
Her body was found this morning. We're very sorry for your loss. I know this is a difficult time, Mr. Tarleton, but we are going to need you to answer some questions. First, we're going to take a look around.
What for? You don't think
this procedure. You see to your girls.
You don't want Rusty getting angry over here. You got any bears? Look how, like, just bored they look. Oh, never mind. Just like, mom's dead. That's, you know.
Stay here till Daddy's finished talking to these men.
Where's Mommy?
Everything's going to be all right, sweetheart.
We would like Mommy to come home now, Daddy.
What's the problem, Carlson? Let him search. You got nothing to hide.
Oh, we'd use a telephone for some reason. Okay.
Want to hear something funny, Carlson? Some bums think filling out a missing persons report actually rules him out as a suspect.
Okay, probably this. Temptations.
Not much help.
What do you mean? What is that, a double dipped? Come on. Can't be licked. Or something. I don't know what that says at the top. I can't read cursive. Alright, here we go. Baron's Bar.
She was a regular. I wonder why the picture was turned down.
Because he had finished masturbating. Come on. Put two and two together, Cole. Victim's handbag.
It was would take a smarter man than me to connect that.
A literal fucking purse, dude. Couldn't possibly put this together. Alright, let's see. Hello, girls. How you doing with the news of your dead mother?
Excuse me, ladies.
Uh-oh.
We can see if Pinker can match the impression of the crime scene.
Uh-oh.
So she went out without her handbag? At least she was spared that particular indignity.
Is that...
She'd have to be in quite a state to leave this behind.
Oh, she's 5'4"? Man, nice. Nice. Nothing wrong with someone being 5'4", you know what I mean? Okay. Wet jacket. Bar that looks awfully suspicious. You went out in the rain. Is that it? Oh, a bow rope. Where the fuck is that?
I'll be out of your way momentarily, ladies.
Daddy, why does the mead man keep talking to us? We really want him to just be quiet.
Bar again. Someone must be real sweet on this dive.
Let's see. Look around the bookshelf, chessboard, matchbook. Head to the bedroom, find the dresser, another matchbook, photo. Search the laundry room, handbag, open. Find a lipstick, which helps. Turn around. Search the yard next to the boat. Okay. Hold on. Sir, excuse me, sir. I gotta go outside real quick. Just real quick. Probably gonna be total. Oh, look at this little tricycle. I like that the game is like flashing a literal light at it. That's like, look at this. You could look at this. Like, oh, okay. I got it. I got you. Is that? All right.
For the record, Mr. Taraldson, what is your wife's name?
Teresa.
Do you have any idea why anyone would want to hurt your wife?
No. Everyone loved Teresa. She was so full of life. It can't be anyone who knew her.
Well, she's not so full of life now.
I think you're lying, Lars. I think you were mad at your wife for embarrassing you in front of your friends. I think you came back here and strangled her and then dumped her body on the hill.
You think I strangled my wife? How do you expect to prove that?
Your wife was strangled with triple braid rope. The bowline from your boat is a perfect match.
Look, I know this looks bad. I'm gonna have to come to terms with the fact that I let her go.
You said you went to a party at Bobby Ross's place?
That's right. Bobby had a bunch of people over. We were having a good time. She said she was bored and decided to leave.
We were having a good time.
You let your drunk wife leave the party and go off on her own?
She's a woman. You can't do that. Like, all right, Cole. Calm it down.
She has to go and ruin it.
She has to go fuck it up.
Last night, she wanted to go dancing.
Any idea where?
Where she always goes. Bar down on North Beaudry Avenue. Baron's Bar.
Baron's Bar.
She goes there, drinks too much, gets maudlin, and calls me. I go and bring her home.
Except for last night, you didn't. Victim state of mind.
Mr. Taraldson, was Teresa happy at home?
Yeah, I think she was.
I think she was. Did you believe that?
Spill it, Taraldson. We like the look of you for this, so you better give us something.
We're at the party. She has a few and says she wants to go out dancing. We only have the sitter until 9. I get mad. I tell her to go ahead, but I'm staying. She storms out. Look, I'm doing well at cards. I hardly ever do well. I married her because she was so much fun, but now she drives me fucking crazy.
What time did she leave the party?
About 8:30. Maybe a little earlier.
We only have the Citadel 9. I'm not paying another $2 an hour. You know he's a cheap piece of shit, right?
When was the last time you saw your wife?
Around 8:30. The card game at Bobby's was wrapping up. I played out my hand and drove home here. Paid the sitter and went to bed.
You're lying, Lars. You didn't come straight home, did you?
And how do you figure that?
You were out in the rain. You got soaked, Lars. We found your wet weather gear.
Okay, I stayed a little later than I said. This cute little brunette was hitting on me. Teresa noticed. I was half cut. I walked her home from Bobby's, but nothing happened. I walked back and got the car this morning.
Thanks for answering my questions, Mr. Tarleton. You'll need to go downtown to identify your wife's body.
Then be sure to call that brunette, because she sounds cute.
In my experience, Mac, be given to broads, you'll be given into them your entire life.
Wow.
We could break the husband's story right now. Call in, get some uniforms dispatched to check out his alibi.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
Why are you yelling, sir?
Can you
calm
run
down
an address for a Bobby
calm
Ross,
down.
Then send some uniforms over.
Would you like him picked up?
No. Suspect says he was with Ross last night. We need to confirm the alibi.
I'll get a prowl car dispatched.
Thanks.
Okay. Time to go to Baron's bar. We'll just leave the door open.
Appreciate
fuck you.
Time, sir.
Was you talking to the teddy bear? Okay.
You believe this guy's story?
Kind of rings true.
This is KTI Radio.
Whoa.
News from Washington.
Da 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 da, the news. Whoa, shortcut.
Girls arrive at Montreal, Canada in a post-war labor experiment by a Canadian industrialist. The girls are part of a group of 100. Will work in a rayon mill at Saint-Georges-de-Beauce, where they will receive the Dominion's minimum wage of $12 a week.
$12 a week? Holy shit.
They'll be taught the rayon spinning process and are under contract for 2 years, during which time they'll be lodged in a conference.
Gents, drink?
Another spoon.
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD.
I'm Benny Clough. This about Teresa Tarleton?
Yes, it is.
I heard about it on the radio. They're saying it was that Black Dahlia freak again? God damn it. Yeah, I rang that husband of hers. The babysitter said he was out.
If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
There's no reason for him to be that aggressive. There's no reason whatsoever. We have a few questions. Like, all right, calm down. I've been very helpful here. Calm down, sir. All right, last contact with victim.
What time did Teresa leave?
Around 10:30, I think.
On foot, in a car, by bus? How was it?
She called for a cab.
Did you get the number?
Sure I did. I like Teresa. The only time she has a drink is when things aren't going so good at home. I was worried about her.
Tried to get her to go back to my place. Didn't work out so well.
Put out an APB on the cab.
3591. Should be traceable.
Two gin, one gin Ricky. Whatever that means. Vagrant male suspect.
Who was she with? We've had reports about a tall, gaunt-looking hobo. He wasn't here last night?
I get plenty of bums in here. But nothing to fit that description.
The likelihood is that whoever she left here with killed her. Give it up, Benny.
All right, two creeps were all over her. promising to take her dancing.
You get a good look at these guys?
Sure. I got a good look. One of them was a sailor in uniform. His cap said, USS Indiana.
And the other man?
The other guy is Richard Bates. He's sitting in the back right now. Red polo.
Uh-oh. Oh no, Richard Bates, you about to get fucked, but not the way you want to be.
Any idea where she was headed?
Nope. I didn't get that.
The husband said she wanted to go dancing.
And she always wants to dance when she's been drinking. She was trying to talk some guys into taking her to one of the dance halls.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Clough. We'll take it from here.
Hey, no problem.
No problem, huh?
This is Bates.
That's him.
LAPD, don't make me chase you, shitbird.
Maybe don't call your shot so early.
Son of a bitch, get away.
Fucking idiot. Get the fuck out of the way. I am young and athletic. You are old and crusty. Get in the car, Phelps.
I thought you were gonna leave me there.
Who knows what this guy will pull when he's cornered? We could have a killer on our hands.
Uh-oh! That car just saved their lives. Holy cannoli.
I don't think the killer would be kicking back in the bar where he meant to pick.
Oh my god,
listen,
that woman.
The creature of habit is your killer. For some reason...
Well, now for sure he's a murderer.
Phelps, you gotta get me closer.
Whoops!
He's showing you how it's done.
Hold on. Hang on. Hold on. We're good. We're okay. You really, slowed up there?
Hit him, Cole. Spin him out. I'll try to shoot out his tires. Wish me luck.
Fuck.
Let's end this part.
Oh my god.
Hit him. Clean this asshole off the road.
He picked the wrong time to flip.
Put your hands where I can see them.
Okay, Bates. You're gonna answer some questions.
I have a choice in this.
Alright, let's see. Interview with Richard Bates. Two just double bad cop, huh?
Last night, you went drinking with a lady in the bar. Now she's dead. And your face is all messed up.
Probably from the wreck, Cole.
On that. She preferred a sailor. You could lay it off on him. Are we finished?
Do you want my partner to sap you? Tell us what we want to know.
She was okay. Drunk. Pissed off at her old man, wanting to go dancing. I thought I'd ply her with a few drinks and get my end away. Looks like your salty had the same idea.
So what happened when you left the bar?
Sailor boy laid one on me. A cheap shot.
He was a sailor boy. She said to you later, boy.
You've done time, haven't you, Richard? Is that why you ran?
I'm on parole.
On what offense?
Sexual assault. Look, I was lying there on the sidewalk. He flags a cab and jumps in with the broad.
We're taking you in, Bates.
How come?
Just for a chat. Nice private chat. I'll explain my theory of once a degenerate, always a degenerate.
You're gonna be really bored. He does not explain that well.
He's a material witness in a murder case. Find him a cozy cell.
Richard here knows the drill.
The drill was my nickname in high school. All right.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
Ooh. Darn it.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an APB out on a yellow cab, number 3591. Ask dispatch to relay all sightings to car 11K.
No problem. I'll get on the radio.
Were there any incident reports filed in the vicinity of Baron's Bar on North Beaudry Avenue? We're tracking a sailor who was involved in a fight outside the bar.
I can check the reports, Detective. I have a message for you from Captain Donnelly. Message reads... James Jessup, U.S. Navy able seaman, has information relevant to
the
case.
Seaman.
Jessup is currently being detained at Central Station.
Could be our man. Thanks for your help.
Okay. Well, thankfully they parked our car really neatly right here. Well, taxi hunting as you drive, you get a call saying the cab has been spotted at a gas station on 7th near Garland. It appears there's a yellow dot on your map. Head there as fast as you can. Okay.
At car 11K, we have a response on your APB regarding yellow cab number 3591. The vehicle has been identified at a gas station. Now heading west on 7th Street.
Hold on, can I... Where is that? Where's the cab? Shit. It's all the way over here. Where the fuck am I? Okay, so it's here. Why is this not on my... Okay, just... There you go. Where's... Hold on, how do I center? Where's me? Oh. Gotta flip a Yui.
Raw's on 7th Street. Let's hit it, Phelps. The cab driver might tie this whole thing together.
I hope you're right.
You see our taxi anywhere?
Sighted at the corner of Wilshire and Whitmer. Repeat, Wilshire and Whitmer, 11K.
Huge.
Where's that cab got to now?
Oh, is this not it?
3591, that's him there, Phelps. Hit the siren.
LAPD, we're investigating a murder.
What's that got to do with me?
The fare you picked up from Baron's bar last night. What was the woman wearing?
It was a green dress. Oh, don't tell me something's happened to her.
Tell me about her.
She was with this sailor, and he was all over her. She wasn't having any of it. Said she just wanted to dance. But he had that look in his eye.
Where did you drop them off?
It's at the Crystal Ballroom.
What time?
After midnight, 12:30, something like that.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
Well, that's gonna ruin my day.
He sounds like he's from New York.
All units in the vicinity in any sentry unit. The 211 is shots fired. 410 South Flower Street. Units that can handle code 3 identified.
All right. That's gonna ruin my day. What am I supposed to do? Now, drive my taxi. I can't. Alright, we're going to Central Station. Oh, got that landmark discovered. Feels good!
Hey, come
on! That car, like, really went. Really just went sailing there. Uh-oh. Don't switch tabs and drive, kids. Wom. Get out of the intersection! Oh, wait, hold on. I think we're here. Please hold. Shit. Get out of the way. An officer of the law here. Just kidding, we weren't really that close. I was off by about a block. Ooh. Inside. Just kidding, two blocks. Don't put the brakes on. Nailed it. crushed it. Cruising to a victory.
He's in interview two.
Interview Thanks. Two.
What do you make of him?
Sailor on furlough, who looks like he's in trouble and knows it.
That guy's like, yeah, I said interview two. It's over here. Exactly. Nope, that's not it. The fuck is interview room two? Oh, it's back here. Hold on. Don't worry, I know. Ah, here we go. Nope, just kidding. That was the wrong one. Oh, it's over here? Oh, probably this one. There it is. Found it.
Phelps and Galloway. We know why you're here, Jessup. So it would be best if you answered our questions truthfully.
I don't want any trouble. That's why I'm here. I heard on the radio about this lady getting killed. I got leave from my CO to come down straight away.
So why did you kill her?
I didn't kill anyone. Look, you need to believe me.
Let's start at the beginning. You went to Baron's Bar. What time did you arrive?
I got a 24-hour pass. I got there around 7.
That's where you met Teresa Terrelson?
Sure. We had a couple of drinks.
So you tried to make a woman who was incredibly drunk?
Look, I'm not proud of myself, but I never hurt her.
You took her dancing?
That's right. Caught a cab to the Crystal Ballroom.
Rusty, you want to, like, back the fuck up? Like, just relax?
A fist fight with Richard Bates over Mrs. Terrelson.
I need your alcoholic breath all
you
over
met
him.
The guy? He's a creep. You should take a look at him for this.
He's pointing the finger directly at you, Jessup.
I only had one night before I was back in the tub. He had all the time in the world to look for some action. I belted him. I'd do it again. She was better off with me.
Sure. You're a shining example of chivalry, Jessup.
Look, I took some shortcuts.
Where did you go after the Crystal Ballroom?
Oh, I think the wind had gone out of her sails by then. She caught a cab, and I caught a bus back to the base.
We spoke to the cab driver. Tell us what really happened at the Crystal Ballroom.
I'd had enough. She was all upset about her husband bawling, about her kids. She looked old. Left around closing, maybe 1:30. Got on a bus, and she fell asleep on my shoulder.
Which bus?
An All-American, 249. I went past her place. She jumped off, and I stayed on it downtown. After that, I caught another bus to San Pedro. The Indiana's down there. She's being scrapped.
And that was the last you saw of Teresa?
Yeah, that's right. We didn't say much. I think she was kind of embarrassed.
The cab driver said that you were getting pretty familiar with Teresa.
That's not how I'd put it.
I was grabbing a boobies.
So the last thing you wanted was her playing hard to get. Did that make you mad, Sailor?
Yeah, it did. She knew what a guy's looking for. All broads do. Dancing comes second.
And what happened?
I always come first.
Nothing. Not even a little hand relief. She had another couple of drinks. There was no fun left in her. She poured her guts out to some bartender.
We're holding you till we can clear this with the driver.
Yeah, my CO said as much.
Oh, this is the best case. We need to go to the bus depot.
The guy in two in a cell Woo. And inform the commander.
Sure, detective. Got a message for you. Sighting of your disfigured hobo on Grand between Temple and Sunset. And it looks like the beau has a record, too. He's wanted in connection with two female assaults.
Thanks.
This is the best case.
Drive all the way to San Pedro and check his locker?
Let's see if the bus story checks out.
There's a depot at 1660.
Beverly yeah, there is. We're going to the bus depot. Woohoo!
Three suspects in the can and one on the hoof. And still no hard evidence on any of them.
Well, one guy had some pretty hard evidence. His penis. Get the fuck out of the way. Get out of the way!
Patrolman reporting that Bobby Ross's car game is breaking up at midnight.
11K, roger that. Plenty of time to get downtown.
It's possible. Have them bring him in.
KTPL, we have Lars Terrelson picked up.
11K, roger.
Nope, going to the bus station. No time. What do you think you're doing trying to change lanes there? Idiot. Can't you see that I'm speeding? Oh god, here they are. The most perfect buses in all of video games, and you can't even frickin' drive them. It's 2:08 p.m. Oh my god. Who the fuck is honking? Oh, look at it. Look at it. It's green and yellow. Oh, number 777. You can't drive it. You can't drive it. That's the only thing you can't drive in this whole fucking game. Aha! This game's a 9.5 out of 10 because you can't drive the goddamn bus. Oh, they didn't even remaster it with the ability to drive the bus. How could they? All right. We have to find a bus map.
And thank you, ma'am. You have a safe trip now. Where are you boys headed today?
LAPD. We're after the driver of All-American 249. Would have been around midnight onwards last night.
Just a minute. Frank Zeffirelli. He's your man.
Where can we find him?
Frank is out on the 7-4.
Can you tell us the route?
Hang on. I should have it mapped out here somewhere.
Oh my god. It's the greatest case in the world. Look at this. It's a bus map. You get to use it to solve a crime. Oh my god.
I'll need to run the loop.
Oh. Look at that. Oh, it's so cool. Alright. Simply drive around the route to find the All-American 74. Keep following the red line.
We're not going to drive the whole thing, are we?
Won't take long. We have a siren.
Sounds like it's supposed to be... If only we could just take this bus. If only we could do that. I didn't get a good look at it. Did it show which way it, like, goes? Well, theoretically it would, because it has directions on the bottom of it, but I don't think you can look at clues.
All-American 7-4, let's go get him.
Shit. No, that's not helpful. Yeah, well, I guess just pick a direction and commit to it.
This could be a long trip, Cole.
Or it could be a short one.
And here's me without my hip flask and only a pain in the ass for company.
Way to kick off the drive in high spirits, Rusty. Comments like that put me in just the right mood for some legwork.
Touchy.
You know what your problem is? You don't like hard work. This kind of rigorous search is what police work is all about. Discipline.
Save it, Phelps. You're just as bored as I am.
No, I'm not. I'm more invigorated and invested than I've ever been because we're driving a bus route. Whoa! I wonder if I will... I was hoping that whatever direction I picked, I was hoping I would cut it off from the front and not, like... Oops. We're good. Catch up to it. But I don't think it had like any arrows or anything. I don't know if you'd even be able to read the text. God damn it, get the fuck out of the way. I don't know if you'd even be able to read the text to determine which way it goes.
Still no sign of him.
Did you doze off, Rusty? I think you slept through my solving the case.
Yeah, yeah, very funny. You just give me a nudge if you see him, all right?
How about you nudge me?
I think that's a job for your wife.
Look!
Oh, Rusty.
Found him. It worked.
There's the bus, Cole. Turn on the siren and pull her over. That's the bus we're looking for. Ease in behind her and get her to the side of the road.
Come on, pull over.
That's the bus we're looking for. Ease in behind her and get her to the side of the road.
There's like... Oh, no! You can't even go on it! No, the door's open. It's I want to be inside you.
LAPD, we're investigating a murder. You had a sailor and a woman in a green dress on your bus late last night.
That's correct.
And the woman got off first, around 2 a.m.?
Yeah, that's right. And the sailor stayed on all the way to downtown.
Can you tell us where you let the woman off?
On California Street. To tell you the truth, she looked a little lost, like she got off on the wrong stop or something. I didn't like dropping her off near that hobo camp.
You've been a big help, Mr. Zeffirelli.
It took off extra fast, so I couldn't try and steal it.
Left her by the hobo.
Which means he's as good as killed.
We can't eliminate any of them, but the disfigured man should be our starting point.
I'm gonna call for some backup. These bows hate cops.
All units, officer needs help. 211 and shots fired. 391 Broadway, Mallory's Cafe, 391 Broadway.
I think we ought to investigate the hobo lead.
Well, if you think we ought to, then I guess we ought.
Gotta get back on this bus. This guy's gonna try and steal it. Now he's behind on his time. It's like, man, the bus simulator game's hard. There. Here we go. Hanging out at the hobo camp. Hoboing, hoboing. Ba-ba-da-ba-da-ba-bum. Up, up, beep, beep. Look out, people! Got hobos to disturb. Up, woo! Those are the sounds Cole Phelps makes when he's driving. Whoa, hee-ho-ho! Oh! Jump time! No! There we go. Nope, gotta go down. Shit. How do I get... Oh, just kidding. Jesus.
LAPD. We'd like a word with you.
Save it for someone who's interested. They're fascists. Come to move us on and steal what little we have left.
Six rounds won't get us far.
I need you to stay copacetic. You need to hold out for the cavalry.
How do we do that?
Like this.
Oh my God.
If you want your rightful share,
these men know they're harboring a murderer.
Lost my head immediately. Jesus. Okay. All right, Cole. Doom. He just. It's 2:59 p.m., but it feels like it's about 2 in the morning. Oh my God! He's gonna get punched in the side of the head, and he's just his expressionless face. This is how it ends. Yeah, we're at almost an hour, and this is only the first case.
We'd like a word.
We'd like. We'd like a word.
They're fascists. Come to move us on and steal what little we have left.
Six rounds won't get us far.
We need you to stay copacetic. We need to hold out for the cavalry.
How do we do that?
Like this.
Jesus. Jesus.
If you want your rightful share,
your disciples know what you did last night?
How do I?
These men know they're harboring a murderer?
Oh, oh.
Under suspicion for murder, Ackerman. We're taking you downtown.
You can't do anything more to me than what the Japanese have already done.
Oh my god. I don't think it showed very well on the Twitch stream, but the guy just went down immediately. Oh my god. Alright.
The Kremlin's over here, Phelps. Toss it, see what you find.
This doesn't pertain to the case.
Is that not a picture of the man that we just beat up? Is that not? It doesn't pertain to the case. Couldn't possibly mean anything.
Still working, Jack. I'm off to the Lighthouse Club in Santa Monica.
Hello, Jack.
Oh, that's right. It has been so long.
He's a buddy of mine from the war. Well, I'm sure you two will want to polish some old war stories. Good evening, Jack. Mr. Sheldon.
Good night, sir.
This is why this desk is so weird, is because all of the cases are seemingly connected, but it's so detached from anything else that happens. Like, it's not the first desk, which is almost like a tutorial desk. It's not like the vice and the arson desks where things kind of start to, like, come together. It's just this desk that, like, exists almost completely by itself. And just every once in a while is like, oh, that's right, there's a newspaper, here's a war flashback. And it kind of, like, tries to keep the overarching stuff going, but it, like, kind of doesn't work. It's so weird.
Take a seat, Courtney.
So weird.
We need your help, Jack. I told you I would have nothing to do with that.
It's also the first time in a long time we've seen Jack.
Medical school's going well. I got a part-time job.
Do dope peddlers need part-time jobs?
We made a mistake and we're in trouble, Jack. A local gangster, Mickey Cohen, is putting on the squeeze.
So hand it over, walk away. What's stopping you?
We had a deal with them, that they would dole it out slowly. They said they would supply abortion clinics and doctors, but they've been moving it on to addicts, and they can't cope with the purity.
So your problem is with gangsters being dishonest?
My problem is that people are dying, and that if this gets back to us, we'll all end up in jail.
So how am I supposed to help, Courtney? This isn't the war. I can't just wave a magic wand and clean up your mess.
We want you to negotiate, Jack.
The only thing these guys understand is force, Sheldon. They got to the top back east by proving to be more vicious than the English, the Irish, and the Dutch. They make their own laws. That's the nature of a secret society. God's sake, Courtney, you want to be a doctor. How can you fight with that?
We are better trained, Jack.
I didn't make it through the war to come back to this kind of shit, Sheldon.
Missing morphine, cops say goons fighting dorp war. Dorp war? Dope war. Derp war. Okay. Um.
Looks familiar. Safe bet it'll match the mark under Teresa Terrellson's chin.
Ooh.
Ackerman doesn't look like much of a dancer.
Isn't that the cop who solved the big case and got promoted?
Yeah. Aren't you the guy that just watched his friend die because my dude ripped out a shotgun and was like, fuck yeah! Murder! Okay. Back to Central Police Station.
The husband has an alibi, but no real motive other than neglect. Jessup's alibi checks out. Bates is a recidivist. He'll be pulling the same stick until we put him away for good. Ackerman has history, opportunity, hard evidence. What motive?
We have the evidence. We know she was here. All we need is a confession and we can charge the bum with murder.
Calling all cars. Citizen reports. Officer needs help. Shots fired. Officer
down. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's a tight tunnel here. Here we go. Okay.
We're going this way.
Ackerman, you were in the Marines.
How do you know?
The Corps selected big guys for flamethrower duty. That's how you got the burns.
Life expectancy was 5 minutes for a guy in flamethrower detail. What kind of a government puts weight like that on a man's shoulders?
You'll get no argument from me. It was a heavy load.
You feeling sorry for this smelly fuck?
What'd you do in the war? Oh, that's right, nothing. Nothing. You were a drunken asshole.
Why did you kill Mrs. Terrellson?
I have no recollection of the people I have killed.
Are you denying that you strangled Mrs. Terrellson with a length of rope?
I'm not denying anything. You have to have proof, lackey.
Probably the bloodstained rope. Ah, fuck. Knew I should have left that on my bedside oil drum.
We found a matching piece of rope in your lean-to. I think we'll find the blood will match, too.
I own no property. How could it belong to me?
Contact with victim.
A bus driver dropped Mrs. Terrellson near your camp around 2 a.m. Why did you take her up to the hill?
Which hill? I have many places. I go where I please.
Okay, dude.
You are clearly insane, Ackerman. The state of California does not execute mental patients.
I don't know the names of the women I've killed, but I've killed many of them. Their necks are so fragile.
Okay.
Where were you around 2 a.m. last night?
At the camp.
You were up on the hill. You were seen during the day. We have a witness. We have evidence. Come clean with me, Ackerman, and I'll see what I can do for you.
I despise your pity. You have nothing that links me to this woman.
Are you sure about that?
We have you cold, Ackerman. Her purse and the ballroom ticket were in your lean-to. Tell us why you did it.
I kill because people need killing. It's what I was trained to do.
Stuart Ackerman. I am charging you with the murder of Teresa Terrellson.
Okay.
A man down on his luck I can abide, but a filthy red who chooses to live outside the rules of society I cannot stomach. Maybe poor Threes of Tarleton will provide the catalyst we need. I've spoken to the chief and the mayor, and I think it's time we send some men in to remove the godless and send them on their way over the county line. A grand day that will be, gentlemen, and a grand result you have brought me. You two are fast becoming my finest crusaders.
I am. Me, Cole Phelps. Rusty sucks. Okay? The dude's terrible. Ayo. Ayo. 5 stars. 5 stars, baby. Oh, here we are. Now we're at the club. Oh, we're going to get a look at our favorite lady. There he is, our main man. You didn't have to push open both doors. One's fine. I'm a fit police officer. I only need one door, buddy. Romance. Don't leave me singing this torch song when I'm burning. Still don't think that's very well fleshed out, like, at all. Just, like, it doesn't make any sense. Uh-oh. Doesn't look good for her. Look out, ma'am, there's a train. There's a train.
Of course we will look into it. Yes, I'm aware that it's an election year. Keep a hold of your hat, Councilor. Now is not the time to lose your nerve. It would appear that someone has hawked a rose gold wedding ring, a matching engagement ring. Mm. Sound familiar?
Deirdre Muller.
Press the pawnbroker and see what you can find out. The address is 348 South Main Street. The Muller case goes before the grand jury next week, and the DA does not want any egg on his face. Then get out to the railroad depot on Santa Fe Avenue. We have another poor unfortunate found this morning beside a railroad line. 40-year-old white woman.
Right, Skipper.
Okay. Time to go to the pawnbroker. I want to
make homicide. Another body and Deirdre Muller's ring. The Emperor may soon have to come to terms with the fact that he's wearing no clothes.
What exactly did you get that book of riddles shoved up your ass, Phelps? Is that what your old man paid college tuition for?
I'm so proud of him catching all of those criminals.
Hello.
Canary says
it me, your detective.
You've got to admit, this is looking odd.
Anyone could pawn a ring.
But if you take it along with all of the other indicators...
Cole, Hugo Muller was identified by the school's groundkeeper. He's our guy.
Witnesses have fingered the wrong guy before.
Oh,
he
gross,
ran,
no.
For God's sakes.
And he always maintained he was set up.
How can I help you, boys?
Get out of the way.
Detectives Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. You have a rose gold wedding and engagement ring?
David Bremner. Am I going to get something for this pledge? Gave that bum money. Now you guys are going to leave me short.
How much did you give?
Uh-oh.
$50?
Try another number.
20?
Try 10. Feel lucky you're getting it.
I have the rings right here.
Hey, reconnected. Okay. We're looking at Deirdre Moeller's ponderings.
What's this mark here?
Maker's mark. Usually traceable. That one came from Hartfield's Jewelry down on Broadway.
Thanks for the tip. Does this mark mean anything?
Hallmark. Gives you an idea of the quality.
What have you got on the guy who brought these in?
Goes by the name of Percy B. Shelley. Gave an address. 15 Poland Street, London, Tulare County.
Can you give us a description of the man who pawned these rings?
Not sure. Medium height, medium build. Dark hair, I think. Sorry. He just had one of those forgettable faces.
We'll be in touch, Mr. Bremner.
So... see, doop a doop a doo. Hallmark stamp, bond broker. Okay. Alright, now we gotta go to the rail yard. And we're off. Jesus!
We have a problem.
We could have the local troopers check out the Tulare County address.
The address is bogus. The perp is having fun with us. The guy who's been sending the Dahlia letters is also the guy who pawned these rings.
How do you figure that?
Percy Bysshe Shelley wrote the poem that came with the Dahlia letter. If the Dahlia letters are genuine, then the man who killed Elizabeth Short may have also killed Deirdre Muller.
And how do we prove that, Phil? Skipper ain't gonna like this one bit.
We're gonna have to rely on this guy tripping up on his own vanity.
Any sentry in at a possible 415 at Alvera Street Plaza unit.
Nah, we're good, we're good. I don't have time. Oh boy. Whoop. Hold. Turn around here. Oh, God. Flub. Seriously? God, where's the GPS tracking when you need it? Nope. Whoa, hang on. I know we got a murder to attend to, but I need to drive this car.
What's your beef with this guy, Phelps?
Did I kill him? What?
You've got to be kidding. We're driving this?
Is that man dead? And all I did was push him a little bit.
Great. How are we going to look getting around in this thing, Cole?
All I did was bump into him. Oh, he fell and hit his head on the car and died. Uh-oh. Well, you'd have your... sir? He just fell. He just... Oh, no. Whoops.
You boys ready? Follow me.
We should keep this development to rings our hat until we speak with the captain.
We're all on the same team, Rusty.
Chain of command, folks. Skipper will decide who needs to know. Got
it. Uh-oh. Oh, never mind. She's clothed.
Yeah. I look after all the rail depots.
What have you got?
The Negro, Nelson Gaines, called it in. I came down here to make sure him and the other guy, Jameson, stuck around.
Jameson found the body?
Something like that. Guy makes me sick.
We'll talk to the coroner. Keep an eye on both of them.
Sir? The fuck is wrong with you? Okay. Dear Evelyn, I hope this letter finds you better than when you last, when we last ranted? Is that, I can't, bitten wounds, bitten, bitter words? Ah, boy, I really can't read cursive. Bitter words were exchanged, you had taken too much liquor, and we both know what that makes you become. But I am not writing to harass and accuse, I am writing to apologize. I was heartbroken seeing what you would what had become of my little girl and what she is doing to herself. You are destroying your own body and your soul with liquor, Evelyn. And
someone was trying to get her to come home.
And it is harder for me to watch you than you can imagine. But only God Almighty above us has the right to judge, and so I beg your forgiveness. I've been in contact with a sanatorium here in Connecticut on your behalf. They say your condition is an illness, Evelyn, and that I can be beaten, I don't know. You only need to check yourself in. It will not ... All right. So
we could go over to the lot and see what they know about her.
The Keystone Film.
Keystone Studio lot closed back in 41.
Oop, another bar for us to look at. What the? Alright, hold on. Just hold it. Still? Why do I need to? There it is.
Maybe someone at Mensch's will remember her.
Okay.
This is a chit for personal items, not booze. It's an angle worth investigating.
That's like the perfect example of what makes this game so odd. Completely, perfectly still body, and then everything from the neck up, like, moves. It's like, oh, okay. Two large suitcase, small suitcase, bedroll, pillow, plain bed sheets, three photo frames, hairbrush, probably rolling pin, maybe a bowling pin, statuette, makeup, clothes. Okay, so we have those. Handbag, but,
blood splatter on the carriage. She must have been struck while standing up.
Another missing ring.
Certainly seems I've been swabbing a lot of bare fingers recently.
Smell?
Very good. There is the usual evacuation smell, but it appears she's been living rough for quite some time.
Very strong smell of alcohol.
Well, the autopsy will tell, but I would assume that she was inebriated.
Can you be more exact about the time of death?
No later than 2 a.m. The state the body was in, a 1 or 2 hour window is the best I can do.
Did I get everything?
What have we got here?
White female, approximately 40 years of age, lipstick smudges on the face, but no writing, at least nothing legible. A blunt force trauma to the temple, nose, and eye regions. Ligature marks point to the probable cause of death being strangulation.
Any idea of the time of death?
From her temperature, after midnight would be my guess.
So did I get the If I get the lipstick? That's not even my...
What are you thinking, Ray?
The city keeps tossing us dead bodies. We're just running to catch up.
So, hold on. How many clues do I have here? Pond rings, handbag. Vagrancy. I don't have a clue about the... let's see. Right. Half-torn letter. Matchbox. Where's the... It says that there's lipstick, but I don't understand where that's supposed to be. Approach the body, talk to him, he points out the lipstick smudges on her face but no writing. Is that it? Handbag, vagrancy. But it says seven clues, and then I don't count the pawned rings because that's a different one. And I just don't see anything about lipstick. Oh, okay, never mind, hold on, I figured it out. The way they list the clues, I feel like I've heard the banana, and still been cost a 5-star for
Detective
missing clue.
Phelps and Galloway, homicide.
It's weird.
Can you tell me exactly what happened?
We were shunting cars over to the main line when I saw this man here lying on top of this woman. The woman wasn't moving and seemed to be in a bad way.
What time was this?
About 7:30 this morning, sir.
Thanks for your help. Have you given Patrolman Hart your details?
I have, sir.
Thank you. You can go now.
Kim? So we talked to him. Now we gotta talk to this fucking guy.
Detective Phelps, LAPD homicide.
John Ferdinand Jameson.
We need you to answer some questions, John.
If you don't mind... I prefer Ferdinand.
Don't push your luck, knucklehead.
What were you doing to the body, Ferdinand?
Are you sure you won't be upset?
Try me, Ferdinand.
I was kissing her. It's not against the law.
Shut up.
There's no law against it.
Take your beating like a man.
Turn out your pockets, Ferdinand.
There's no law against it. Okay, they're gonna call it the Ferdinand Law. And, fuck.
Classic Carmine.
Okay. There we go. Now we can look at it. Alright. Now we have the lipstick clue.
Is this yours, Ferdinand?
No. I found it near her purse. I thought she could use some lipstick.
Rusty, stop! Don't hit him.
Shoot your shotgun. Shoot him with your shotgun. Interference with evidence.
You went through her purse?
It wasn't like she needed it. Took a look.
Did you take any money?
Wasn't any to take. I found her lipstick and her matchbook over on the mat. Not much else.
You found the body?
Yes, I did. I work here. I was coming off shift and headed home.
I work here. At the... train yard. That's what that says, right? The bus station.
Why didn't you report the body, Jameson? Do you know how this is going to look to a jury?
A jury? What gives? I could tell that she was dead. I came through here about midnight last night. She wasn't here then.
Let me belt him again.
You're under arrest, Jameson. We'll see how this plays out. Until then, you can think a little on how you'd like to be treated if you were found dead.
I'm telling you, it's not illegal. Me and some friends of mine...
Clyde. You get this sack of shit into a cell, I'll deal with him later.
Sure, me and some friends of mine. Sir, you have friends? How? By friends, do you mean sex dolls? They didn't have those in 1947.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, detective?
I need an address on Levine's Liquor, closest store to the Santa Fe Avenue rail yard, if possible.
Just a moment, detective. Closest store would be the one at 939 South Hope Street.
Thank you.
Okay. So now we're going to Mensch's Bar.
Read that those goddamn Chinese want to sell the relief food that we're sending them?
Yeah. Yeah, I read about that.
People are starving. They can't do that.
Want to sell the food to fund the civil war against the communists.
Really? Guess that's okay, then.
Armies can't fight without food. You spend all your money on weapons, but you still have to have the will to fight. Fortunately, the Reds will win in China.
Watch your mouth. You know what you're saying?
The people of this country overthrew a king. You think the Chinese will balk at an emperor if they are starving?
Grosvenor McCaffrey. This is a name that seems familiar. And not just because I played this game like four times. Woo!
Whoa there!
Whoa! I'm not drunk enough for this. Ho-ho! Ah! Intersection! Oh, we got the L ray. Oh, look out! No! That sign keeps disappearing. Alright, where are we going? Am I getting close? Go ahead and go left here. Look at that. Cool. Nope, just kidding. That's not where we're going. Hold on. Hoot. Turn around. That does not go through at all. Whoops. Oh, shit. I already killed a man. Look out. Okay, Mensch's Bar, talking to Grosvenor McCaffrey. Then we gotta go to the liquor store.
Drink, fellas. Phelps, Galloway, homicide. We need to ask you some questions concerning Evelyn Summers.
I'm Walter Mensch. Evelyn Summers, what is it now?
You knew Evelyn?
As well as I wanted to know Evelyn. She's a pain in the ass, always Wait, coming in what? Here.
Who is
drinks,
this guy?
Never had any money. She was in just a couple of nights ago.
Did she ever tell you where she was staying?
I don't know. I think she was living rough. She had that kind of stunk about her.
Who did she drink with?
A bunch of these guys. Ask around.
Wait, who did we talk to? Who? Hold on. This guy looks so familiar.
What are we waiting for?
Accused of having communists and communist sympathizers in our employ. Undoubtedly, there are such persons in
So he's like a real film actor. Hold on. God, he looks so familiar. Why is he in this? 2.5 Men, L.A. Noire, Big Bang Theory, Anger Management, the TV series. Remember when they bought 100 episodes of Anger Management, the TV series, with Charlie Sheen? Because they were like, hey, you know what? You know what? Charlie Sheen, he's hot right now. We'd like to... There it is. That's what it is. He's in Scrubs. That's exactly what it is. Charlie Sheen got kicked off of 2.5 Men. So let's go ahead and...
What's your name?
Let's commit to 100 episodes of this show.
Mind if I ask you some questions?
Oh, man.
Mr. McCaffrey?
FX is like a...
Writer, detective. What do you want to ask about?
Evelyn Summers and why she was found beaten and strangled in the rail depot on Santa Fe.
Okay. I see your point.
How well did you know her?
I can't say that I knew her. It was more like I was aware.
Sir, your book is freaking out on the table. FX is like a widely, like, well-regarded stuff. Like, FX is widely regarded and, like, well-known for its good original programming. But Anger Management, I'm sure, is one that they would be like, we'd like to get rid of this. We'd like to, if we could just erase people's memory of that, that'd be great. You can just think about Sonny and Archer and Sons of Anarchy and Fargo and all this, like, other really incredible shit. Oh, man. All right. Now that I've solved that mystery, Grosvenor McCaffrey, last contact with victim.
Did you see Evelyn last night?
No, I was at home, writing.
Do you want to get dragged into this, McCaffrey? Do you want us to get interested in you?
She hung out with this powder puff, James Tiernan. They haunted the public library together.
How well do you know James Tiernan?
I know he works some kind of plebeian job at Rawlings Bowling Alley.
Rawlings? I know that place, corner of 9th and Grand. A lot of cops bowl there on Tuesday nights.
Thank you, Rusty. Maybe next time, just shut the fuck up.
Do you have a criminal record, Mr. McCaffrey?
Nothing serious. I've had a few skirmishes.
Do you want to save me some time, or do you want me to look up your file?
Industrial disputes, strikes, workers' rights, that kind of thing.
A regular fifth columnist. Nice to meet you, comrade.
Thank you for the information, Mr. McCaffrey.
Rank 17. All right. Do we come back to Mensch's bar? Broadcasting at 760 kilohertz. Oh, okay, we do. All right. Now we're going to the liquor store. What's your favorite place, Rusty? The liquor store. You probably know this one well. You drunken bastard.
What did you make of McCaffrey?
There'll come a day, and it's coming very soon. We'll run him and the rest of his pinko buddies out of Los Angeles.
I meant as a suspect, Rusty.
Nothing? I think he's hot. What do you want me to tell you?
Do for you.
LAPD, Phelps and Galloway. We're making inquiries into the murder of Evelyn Summers.
Evelyn? She's dead?
You knew Evelyn Summers, Mr.
Robbins? Yes, I knew Evelyn. I was a good friend of her ex-husband. She kept some of her stuff here.
Can you show us, please?
Sure. Come this way.
This guy's like trying to help out.
Fine stock here, Mr. Robbins. Well, you
let us taste them for the road, this case might get solved a lot quicker.
He's joking, Mr. Robbins.
She kept a bed here, but I probably shouldn't have let her. An alcoholic in a liquor store, that was never going to work out, was it?
We'll take a look around. I'm guessing Evelyn hadn't held down a job for quite some time before she was killed.
That's all we're looking for. Oh, it is a bowling pin. It is a bowl. It's a literal. Okay.
She wasn't always such a loner. Evelyn was reading Aristotle.
Evelyn wasn't stupid. The only stupid thing about her was her need to drink.
And she was borrowing books from Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Okay. All right.
We're trying to account for Evelyn's movements yesterday.
She came by in the morning.
A social visit? To pick up some of her things?
She had a couple of bucks and bought a quart of rye.
Any idea where the money came from?
She didn't mention it. But she did say the booze was a present for a boy. She said they had been fighting and she had to make it up to him.
Were you and Evelyn close, Mr. Robbins?
Not many people will be sad she's gone. I'll be one of the few.
We got the impression that Evelyn had been sleeping rough of late.
It became difficult for me to have her staying here. Her mother was trying to get her back on the straight and narrow. She's old now. And to be honest, you have to have a good reason to want to get back on.
Do you know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
We're struggling for leads, Robbins. Did she know McCaffrey?
She idolized him. From what I gather, the feeling was far from mutual. He seems to peddle a revolutionary stance, fixing the ills of society. You could see how it would appeal to down and outs like Evelyn.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Robbins.
No problem. Hey, I'd like to make arrangements for the funeral. You think I could get in touch with Evelyn's mother?
Put in a call to the watch commander at Central Station, Mr. Robbins. He'll be trying to reach the next of kin.
Thanks. Get the guy, huh? Evelyn never hurt anybody.
Damn, we didn't even get any booze. Rip.
Car 11 King.
A message from Captain Donnelly. Return to Central. Go to
11 King. En route. Let's not keep the man waiting, Phelps.
Back in the car, I'm gonna call the dumpster.
Putting rain in my eyes.
Ah, gotcha. If you don't do this now, you miss the clue. Interesting. One of the few times the game actually tells, or the guide actually tells you to drive somewhere. Everywhere else is like, fast travel here, fast travel there. But you still need to get the 194 miles? Which is like, kind of weird. So I don't know, 194.7 miles driven, which is like, oh, so now you're gonna have to burn a bunch of time later? I don't know. It's weird.
You say you barely knew Evelyn?
Yes, that is correct.
You're lying, McCaffrey. You looked down your nose at Evelyn, but you knew her, and you have some idea of what happened.
I hope you're holding aces. I'm telling you again, I barely knew the woman.
I barely knew the woman.
Why would you lend her your book on metaphysics if you only knew her in passing? It was more than that. A Renaissance man like yourself lending his books to his acolytes.
She hounded me about that goddamn book, and then she lifts it from my apartment and lies to my face that she didn't take it, as if she could even comprehend any of it. I saw her go into a hotel with Tiernan last night. They had booze in a paper bag. He's your man.
Okay. Now we're going to the Central Police Station. Oops. And that's why it's not crossed out. It's because you still need it. I bet a lot of people miss that clue the first time they play through. Parked perfectly.
The captain is downstairs with Ray Pinker and Carruthers.
Whoa.
What's this about, Captain?
Ray and Mal have some concerns over the Henry and Muller cases, which I don't want aired outside of this room.
The evidence is solid, Captain.
I agree, Rusty. It's just that corpses keep piling up.
Copycats.
I've been banging the same drum. But the notes and the lipstick messages.
Evelyn Summers, Cartel Classic Carmine. Each woman, same brand, same color.
Teresa Terrelson didn't have a lipstick message.
Technically, you're right, Rusty. She didn't have any lipstick. But she did have a message. We found it beneath her dress, scraped with a sharp stick.
What did it say?
You sure you want to know,
Ray? As far as we can be sure, it said, cunt BD.
That's one way of looking at it.
Looking at what?
Cunt is all about access, Phelps. You're married, yours is mortgaged. Some of us like to pay by installments. This guy doesn't like to pay at all.
Why are you so angry, Mal? Because I just had to fire one of my assistants. He was a friend of Jameson's. God knows what he might have been up to.
Captain, we have good leads in the Summers case. But it's up to you to decide how we proceed.
Keep this under your hat for now. And follow up on Evelyn Summers. I want daily reports.
Okay. Now we're going to go to the bowling alley. Who's ready to bowl 300?
Back to the Summers case. Get an address for McCaffrey, who will have blown the bar. I'll meet you outside.
Wait, hold on. Can I really use a phone in the police station?
Operator, give me R&I.
Are you calling from inside the building? Just come upstairs. Or
Phelps,
upstairs.
1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address for a Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Grosvenor McCaffrey. Apartment 6, 126 Yale Street, between Ord and Alpine.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Let me pose a question.
Depends. What you got to do with?
Morals. Would it bother you to put the wrong person away?
Depends.
On what?
On whether anyone except the poor son of a bitch in the slammer ever found out.
You sense a cake. Now that's thrifty. With its flower-like fragrance, it's a Hollywood secret. Ask your grocer for Pandora brand soap today.
Thirteen of 26 cases. Oh boy. 90.39 miles driven so far.
All units, officer, need to tell 211 and shots fired.
I've driven another like 50 miles. Oh god. No, 100 more miles. Oh my, that's so far.
Not the only cop in this town.
Hates to have to think things over. 194.7 miles, I think is how much it is. God. I'm not even halfway there. What an exciting video game. You can go to a bowling alley and a bus station. Woo!
Hello, Rusty. Two on your usual lane?
I'm Detective Phelps. Homicide.
You must be new. What's your shoe size?
It's just business, Florence. You got a guy works here by the name of Tierney.
Look at Rusty turn on the charm.
He's a pin setter. Clears the jams, works the gutters. Go right in. He'll be hopping around the lanes toward the back. He's a nice boy.
Thanks, ma'am. Let's go get him.
Uh-oh. A little urgency here, Cole.
Tiernan! LAPD!
What are you waiting for? Get after him!
We might go faster if we weren't carrying the extra weight. These are flashy cars to be parked outside a bowling alley.
The lanes attract a fast-living individual with money to burn.
Or a middle-aged individual with the need to feel virile.
Keep it steady! Oh. I'll try to bust his tire!
I know, you had it.
Hit him! Clean this asshole off the road!
Hit the tire, dude.
Another runner. Well, at least we've got a suspect.
Why do they always run? I'm sure we've got the wrong person in more than one of these homicides, but they always seem to land it.
You know, your theories are not airtight by any means.
Oh my god, Russ. Please.
That is the end of that. It's about fucking time.
If this isn't the killer, we can at least... Give it up, LAPD!
Now, do I want to keep this car or not? Doesn't look like it. There's one case where you can, like, get the... What? I don't... Okay. I guess we're doing this real quick.
To the rear of the building, sir. Someone's gonna have to climb up and take him down.
Good luck. Don't let him get a bead on you like I did.
Cop killers are the worst kind of scum.
By lunch, he means scotch. And by second, he means, like, eighth.
You like killing cops?
Won't help console the officer's family.
He took four shots to the shoulder. Do we get my car back? Oh, I do. Hell yeah.
A cigarette made better. Bullseye smokes better than other leading brands.
Now, where am I going?
Yes, Bullseye cigarettes. It's the tobacco that matters. Independent tobacco experts.
Ah, McCaffrey's apartment. Whoops. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Come on. Give me the achievement. Maybe this isn't the car that the guide was talking about. I don't even really know how to tell how fast you're going. Nothing? Nothing for that? Whoops.
Slow and steady, come on.
What? Come on what? Keep the needle above 80 miles an hour for 10 seconds while driving. The studio secretary murder. Yeah, this is the one. It's a fast car. Still have the car. Follow the metro rails at full speed. Weird. I thought that was the car that we would need to use.
McCaffrey is in apartment 6.
I don't know where that is. 3? Is it like on 4? Second floor, I guess? I just gotta look for the gold-handled door. That's the key. Open the fuck up! It's the fucking police,
bitch!
Look
like anybody's home.
Kick in some doors.
Terrible shame. Means there's nobody to let us in. You wanna do the honors, Phelps?
Oh, boy, that's very bad.
He said he was at home. He said he didn't know her. And we have the book.
I see Carruthers argue his way out of this one.
Oh.
Is that you, Grosvenor? Who are you guys? What are you doing in here?
We're from the LAPD, ma'am. Do you know where we might find McCaffrey?
I'm his neighbor. Is he in trouble?
Look, lady,
oh,
we
shit.
Need to find him, and in a hurry. Are you going to give me trouble?
He has a pigeon coop up on the roof.
Ah, fuck.
This morning,
so do I need to get that other one first?
How do we get up there?
Down the hall and up the stairs.
Drunk and in command of a carrier pigeon. Surely we can ride him up to that. A citation, please.
Where's the... Fuck. Where's the fucking letter? Hold on. Oh. Nope.
Doesn't look like anything.
Living room on the left to find the bottom half of the letter. Oh. Oop. Actually, no. That's not. Take long before you are healed, but you can come home. I have put your things back in your old, room. With a lock on the door for privacy, and you can come and go as you please. I will care for you, and you can return to your normal life. I know your address has changed, so I cannot be sure this letter will find you.
From the letter we found beside the body. At the very least, I'd say it ties McCaffrey to the scene.
But I pray that it does, and that you will consider what I have said. I love you very much, and I pray every night that you are safe, and that one day you will knock on my door, and the rift between us will be mended. With love and understanding, your mom, mother, Augusta. Augustus Gloop! Hilarious. It's me, Augustus Gloop. I'm gonna get stuck in a pipe now. Hello, ma'am. Are you smoking inside? Bitch, you're gonna burn the fucking whole thing down. God damn it.
The cop who solved the big case and got promoted?
Shut the fuck up. Look at that painting of a dog. Where's the fucking... here we go. What are you doing? Hey! What are you doing? Get away from the road.
Grosvenor McCaffrey! Running on a hangover, McCaffrey? Sit down and we'll talk!
Better get our fucking wheels. How did I not get that achievement? Driving me nuts. Oh.
You a runner, McCaffrey? Stay and fight the good fight.
This is one of those.
Give it up, LAPD.
There he is, officer.
Yeah, thanks. I can see him. Thanks. Oh, he's running out of stamina. Look out. We're catching him. Oh, just kidding.
Don't make me chase you. McCaffrey, you're under arrest on suspicion of murdering Evelyn Summers.
I was going to attack. They just stopped and turned him around. I was supposed to tackle him. What? How does that make any sense?
Get downtown and wrap this thing up. It's got to be McCaffrey. Unless Terranin set him up. You don't think that asshole Jameson could have done it, do you? Whoever did it. So what's that Dahlia fuck?
How do you know that McCaffrey didn't do the dog?
Central Police Station.
We
this
have
is
a
the
list
car.
Over 200 suspects. His name was never on it.
If you think the list is exhaustive, Rusty, who am I to argue?
Listen, let's just work the case at hand, shall we? Then we can sit
Whoops.
Down and put all the puzzle pieces together at a later date.
I'll hold you to that.
Oh, I have made an error. Uh-oh. Come on. So we get it all the way. All the way. We're going full speed. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There it goes. There
breathe,
we go.
Breathe, damn it.
I'll be honest, I may have cost myself a 5-star rating in doing that, but at least I got the 15 gamer score. Whew, thank God. The guide says that once you see... I had that counted out perfectly, too. Once the guide sees you... the guide says once you see it saving, that's when you're good. Okay. So here we go. James Tiernan.
You sure you can make it stick with one of these suspects, gentlemen?
It's either McCaffrey or Tiernan, sir. I think Jameson is an aberration.
All right. I'll deal with that degraded lunatic myself. He's got some fearful retribution coming. Tiernan isn't one, McCaffrey isn't two. I want the confession from one of them.
So we are going to go... we are going to go talk to Tiernan. Shit. Which one's which? Hold on. Okay. First head to interview room one. Okay, good. This guide is so thorough. It is, like, kind of weirdly thorough, but, like, it's actually good.
I was the last one to see Evelyn that night. I knew you would think it was me.
Relationship with the victim.
Can you describe your relationship with Evelyn?
I barely knew Evelyn.
Keep lying to me and I'll have
victim
you charged
last
and in
scene?
Front of a grand jury before your feet touch the ground.
How can you possibly prove Evelyn and I were more than friends?
McCaffrey gave you up, Tiernan. He says he saw you go into your hotel with Evelyn.
I met Evelyn at the public library. We would read for a while and then go for a drink. Last night, we went back to my hotel room and had some more to drink. I must have passed out. I woke up and she was gone.
What time was this?
Around midnight, maybe later.
And there's no one who can confirm this.
No, there isn't. I knew you wouldn't believe me.
Victim's book found.
Aristotle's Metaphysics, the book that belonged to McCaffrey.
McCaffrey saw her looking at her once and laughed in her face.
And you're saying Evelyn stole it?
She wanted something of his.
We either hang this on you or McCaffrey. You better give us something.
Well, McCaffrey's been in trouble with the law before. I mean, he always makes out it was some kind of labor dispute. But, you know, I'm not so sure.
Okay. Alibi for James Tiernan.
You and Evelyn were drinking together last night. And she had no other place to stay.
I don't know what happened last night. I don't remember.
You're lying, Tiernan. You'd been fighting with her. You fought, and
I'm not lying! She got up and left, that was it!
She left, but she came back. She bought you a quart of whiskey to make it up to you. She told the liquor store owner. You're in deep trouble, buddy.
She said she loved me. She wanted to care for me. She would never stop talking about McCaffrey. McCaffrey was a writer, and McCaffrey was a hero. McCaffrey cared for the little guy.
Did you kill her, Tiernan?
I might as well have. Kicked her out. She had nowhere to go.
Access to murder weapon.
Do you own a car, Tiernan?
No, I don't.
Have access to a lug wrench?
We use a lot of them to clear jams in the pin setting machines.
Coroner's report says that Evelyn was killed with a wrench. I think you did it and then planted the evidence at McCaffrey's apartment for us to find.
We went to his apartment. McCaffrey was up on the roof. Evelyn stole the book. McCaffrey went crazy when he found out. He said he would put her out of her misery. He can be very cruel.
Evelyn was missing a ring from her right hand.
That's strange. She always wore it. A big black circular disc with a white E in the middle. It was made from an old typewriter key, present from the prop department at her old movie studio.
We're going to talk to McCaffrey. You need to think about what you've told us, Tiernan. You're not in the clear.
All right. Interview room 2. Which we should know where it is because we had to find it earlier. Hey, look at that. Found
it. Took a swipe at me. Put him down with my sap.
You ready to answer some questions?
You think I have all the answers?
Oh, God, this dude sucks.
Usually have something to hide.
Touché, detective. Let's see where this takes us.
This dude like comes across as like a dude who thinks he's a criminal mastermind, but like meh.
Evelyn died sometime around midnight.
Torn letter.
Remind me, where were you?
I was at home, writing. I'm working on a manuscript.
You're lying, McCaffrey. You were out at the rail yard.
And what do you have that proves I was there?
How about half of Augusta Summers' last correspondence with her daughter?
What are you talking about?
After you were done beating Evelyn, you searched her and found her mother's letter. That old lady's anguish amused you.
I know nothing about a letter or Evelyn's goddamn mother.
So what was it doing on your writing desk?
I don't know, but if I didn't put it there, somebody else did. Try exercising your powers of deduction on that.
Access to tire iron?
We found the lug wrench that Evelyn was battered with in your apartment, and the note from her mother, and your blood-stained clothing. We have you cold, McCaffrey.
You think if I could be bothered to murder Evelyn Summers, I would be stupid enough to leave the evidence in my apartment?
Yes, I do, actually.
I don't believe you, Grosvenor. The evidence says that you killed her.
You can prove that I wanted to kill Evelyn?
Tiernan is prepared to testify that you threatened Evelyn's life in his presence.
Self-preservation. That's understandable. Okay, I'll level with you. Tiernan killed Evelyn. He came to me for help. I listened to him, and he explained why he did it.
Tiernan went to you for help. You expect me to buy that?
That's how it went down. I told him he made a terrible mistake, but he would be throwing his life away if he went to the cops. I took his things and told him I would dispose of them.
But you didn't.
Speak to Tiernan. He'll give it up.
Okay.
Need a drink. I got the jitters again.
Do I use the telephone now, or... Well, hang on, we'll just... go this way. We'll follow it the way the guide says.
You spoken to McCaffrey? I can go? It's all been cleared up?
Not quite. We have one more question we need to ask, James. Then I think we will be done.
Sure. Go ahead.
So Evelyn passed out, and you walked out. What happened next?
I woke up in the morning, very hungover. I thought Evelyn would have come back.
I know you're lying, James. You went out looking for her. Tell me what really happened.
I don't know what you're talking about. How can you say I wasn't in that hotel room?
You wound up at McCaffrey's. You were still incredibly drunk. You passed out on his floor. It's time to tell me what really happened.
McCaffrey woke me up the next morning. And he showed me the lug wrench and the letter and the box. And he said I came in with him last night. He said that I killed Evelyn. And that it was all over the radio. And that he would protect me. And I don't know, Detective, for the life of me, I can't remember a goddamn thing. I was angry with her. Really angry. I could have done it. Was it me?
All right. Now leave. Now we're going to call R and I. We're getting close to that rank 20.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need the jacket on a Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Just a moment, Detective. McCaffrey was formerly under surveillance by the Red Squad. Convictions for petty theft. Dishonorable discharge from the Army during training at Syracuse.
Good God.
Thanks for your help.
I'm just praying the prince come through so I can nail the son.
You were in the war?
Yes, I was. Seeing the things that I saw. It changes a man.
Oh boy, let me call the academy.
To change things. All I wanted was a pen and an opportunity to speak out.
You told us before that you had only minor run-ins with the police. You didn't mention petty theft.
I've never been in trouble for violence. That's the salient point here, isn't it?
You're lying, McCaffrey. You have a history of violence towards women.
How do you turn a couple parking tickets and a petty theft misdemeanor to an assault charge?
Because you beat a woman, you fucking idiot. You overly clever bastard.
We know all about you and your dishonorable discharge, beating some poor woman near to death in Syracuse. You've never been in combat, McCaffrey. Your whole life is a fraud.
She was a goddamn peasant whore. She tried to steal from my wallet. I could have fought for this country. I could have...
You beat her because she stole from you. Because she tried to outsmart you.
The ignorant audacity of the bitch. What is a man supposed to do? Sit there and take it? How is a man supposed to call himself a man?
And Evelyn Summers, a poor, drunken nobody, stole your book.
And she got what was coming to her.
Well.
Grosvenor McCaffrey, I'm charging you with the murder of Evelyn Summers. She was a sad lady who never hurt anyone except herself. I hope God finds a way to forgive you.
Noise. Fucking got him.
Congratulations, boys. You bagged the fine catch. Another red to boot. Grand. Now,
want you to put this business about a repeat offender out of your mind. This McCaffrey creature shows no remorse, and neither will the grand jury. You would have to walk a long mile to find a better candidate for an unmarked plot in a prison graveyard.
Look at him, Stu. Look at him do it. He's like, fuck. Too clever for my own good. Okay, now we did get it. Alright, cool. Thank fucking God. Grosvenor McCaffrey can write a tell-all memoir from his cell on death row. That's the case note. Alright, last case of the homicide desk here.
We have lost most of Shaughnessy and Dunn's squad. The gunny is dead, first platoon is in worse shape. That medic is either crazy or the bravest man alive.
Can we rally with the first? Then try for the Namboots.
It's sheer to the left. To the right, it goes right through a pass with two Namboots and Infilade.
Mate,
we can lose everyone.
Mate, Lieutenant! Get back off this fucking bridge! They'll start walking the mortars back to their own positions. We only have
minutes. I'm in charge here, Sergeant.
Get your men off the bridge, Lieutenant.
What's your unit, Sergeant?
We don't have time for this, Lieutenant.
What's your unit, Sergeant?
My company, 22nd Marines, Lieutenant. And we just saved your ass by fording the river.
My orders are to reconnoiter the...
I think that point is now moot. You have 10 men left. My orders are to save what's left. Move out!
All right, one more homicide desk case. Getting close here. It's the end of part five or whatever. Let's see.
Well done, lads. We did well with the Summers case, but we have a problem. The examiner received a new letter today.
Do you mind if I take a look, Ray?
Go right ahead. They've both been rinsed in gasoline, like the previous letters, so I can't lift a print.
Part four? I think I said that earlier. Alright.
No one else but the killer knew about this message.
Cunt BD, find me where I hid myself. Alright.
To suffer woes which hope thinks infinite, to forgive wrongs darker than death or night.
To defy power which seems omnipotent, to love and bear, to hope till hope creates, from its own wreck the timing it contemplates, neither to change nor falter nor repent, this, like thy glory, Titan, is to be good, great and joyous, beautiful and free. This is alone life, joy, empire, and victory.
Another snippet from the Shelley poem.
Looking to wander up to heaven, while yet the music pealed along, I hid myself within a fountain in a public square, where I lay like the reflex of a moon, seen in a wave under green leaves.
If the note is from the Dahlia maniac, he definitely also killed Teresa Terrellson.
Mal and I agree.
But where does that leave us? If this is the Dahlia killer, and he is responsible for the Tarrelson murder, not to mention the Mueller.
Hang on a moment, Skipper.
Let me finish, Rusty. We have five birds in hand and none in the bush. The department will not survive.
Rusty's heard that from a lot of women. Let me finish, Rusty.
First. Your careers will be over for a start, gentlemen.
Looking in wonder.
Ah, fuck it. I knew this run was too good to be true.
I hid myself within a fountain in the public square.
You like that stuff? What is it supposed to mean?
Forget what it's supposed to. What does he want?
Where are you going with this, Cole?
He's obviously taunting us. He believes he's far more intelligent than we are.
Okay, it's some kind of story, right? A guy that God hates, chains him up.
It's an allegory, Rusty.
A what? A story with two meanings. A symbolic meaning. But that's what he wants us to think.
Could he be using it literally? Within a fountain in a public square? Could it be that easy?
Somebody tell me what the fuck is going on?
The fountain in Pershing Square. Come on, we have a clue. Captain, thanks, Ray.
Be careful, Phelps. This is his game you're playing now.
Or her. Alright, here we go. Rank 18. Two more ranks to an achievement. I'll be unlocking 15 gamer score here in a little bit. Can you excuse me, sir? Alright, now we gotta go to the Pershing Square Fountain.
I wanna make homicide.
I wanna make homicide. This is my car from the last case. Are you really gonna... Oh, you're going all the way around? Alright, sir.
Officer needs help. 103 NV.
All those cases, Rusty. What have I been telling you all along?
We gotta get this guy.
I know. Enough women have died.
Yeah, and it's our asses on the line too, Phelps. You heard what the captain said. The department is not going to take responsibility for all those bad convictions.
Success is a double-edged sword.
Let's just get this sick pervert and have it done with.
Oh, there's a nice trolley line there in the background. Green and yellow, hell yeah. Social security card. Yeah, I think this one's a lot... This one's a lot quicker because it's the culmination of like the rest of this.
Rather you than me, Phelps.
The whole case situation.
You know the local hobos use that as a latrine.
The local hobos. All right, there is a cave, all overgrown.
There is a cave, all overgrown with trailing odorous plants which curtain out the day. Where next?
Which curtain out the day with leaves and flowers and paved with feigned emerald and a fountain leaps in the mist with an awakening sound from its curved roof of the mountain's frozen tears like snow or silver or long diamond spires hang downward raining forth a doubtful light. And then we gotta pick up this other thing, social security card.
Elizabeth Short.
Betty Short. The Black Dahlia.
Black Dahlia.
The Black Dahlia. Okay.
Elizabeth Short's social security card.
Jesus Christ.
That's not all. There's another stanza from Shelley.
Can you work it out? You got a city map? See if you can work out where he's taking us. I don't like this freak leading us around by the nose.
Hold on, I just want to... Use the map to study landmarks and set a destination. I do want to look at this cool trolley car over there. So, over here, though. I don't know if I have ever seen this. Oh, it's a trolley. That's a hot dog stand? Oh, that is cool. I don't think I've ever seen this before. That is awesome. Cool. Hold on. Hold on. Toggle UI. Look at that. LA Noire. Then we take off the webcam. All right, there we go. There's a thumbnail. That's a little more interesting than some of the other stuff that I've had.
I'm out of here.
All right. Well, thankfully, I don't have to look at the map for it because I have a guide that'll tell me where I need to go. It's the Hall of Records. That's where we're going.
Wasn't great.
I love these waitresses.
The KCB Network presents National News from Washington.
Actually, pretty sure that that's where we're supposed to... I think that's the final destination. We have to try and find the Hall of Records, wherever that is. Main Street Terminal. I don't actually know where this is. Where the fuck? LA Public Library? No. Ah, fuck. You have to decipher the clue yourself. The keywords refer to an overgrown mountain cave with a frozen fountain hanging down from its curved roof. Open up your map and move the location of the Hall of Records, which is a couple blocks northeast of your current location. The pop-up text mentions a dome skylight. Okay, so... Angel's Flight. So it's northeast. I may not even have it unlocked. Oh, there it is. There it is. I didn't realize it was actually my literal map that you have to use in the game. For some reason, I don't remember that. Okay.
Him. It's really him, the fuck who killed the Dahlia. Can you believe this? He's leading us.
It's his game, Rusty. He may want someone to catch him, but he's extremely dangerous. I doubt if he will give up easily.
Suits me down to the fucking ground. We clip this fuck and we get citations. What a day to be a cop. Depends on pushing Parker will be able to shove me aside after this.
Any central unit, car 16L reports a possible jumper at 8th and Hope. The Methodist Church units have a code to identify.
Oh my god, look at this parking lot of cars. There's so many cars to drive. Ah! Alright, hold on. Pick up a couple here. Damn it. That one's not even a good one. Not even a good one. Get this one? Oh god. And so it begins. All these cars look the same. I can't figure out which ones are different. Oh man. There we go. 25 and 95. Only 70 to go. Jesus. Oh my god.
It's nip and tuck.
Okay. What do we have? Is there, like, really anything else here? I think I tried that yellow car. We're, like, on the hunt for, like, a serial killer, and Cole Phelps keeps just entering and exiting cars. Have I driven this one? I have. Damn it. Let's move on to the next one. This looks new, maybe? No, it's not. It's absolutely not. Absolutely not new. This one on the end actually might be, though. I don't see anything else. Has a... This is a pretty quick case. Spends the 8 minutes. Yeah, this one's gotta be new. There we go. 26 of 95. I had 94 of 95 for, like, months in this game. Like, I looked 4 hours trying to find the final one. And, when it happened, I was so shocked. Couldn't believe it. The achievements popped, and I was like, does somebody come pinch me? This is a dream. God dang it. Maybe this one? But I kind of doubt it. Oh, cool. This one for sure I've already driven. 27 of 95. I think... Oh my god, really? Wow, that is surprising. Well, I'm glad I checked. Okay, so we gotta go here to the Hall of Records. I think this is the case that I would have to load up a bunch.
Can I help you, sir?
Detectives, LAPD. This is very important, sir. How do we get to the top of the chandelier?
You what?
Have a little faith, pal. We're in a real hurry.
Head up to the top floor. There's an access panel and a ladder in the maintenance room.
It's like a... Oh. Oh, okay. Cool. All right. Land registry. We go this way. That's weird. That's the first time I've ever seen one of those. There's 20 of those hidden in the world. I was gonna just get all those collectibles at once. There's golden records, books, and badges, I think, that are like all separate achievements. That I was gonna try and do.
Let's go.
I wanna swing from the chandelier. From the chandelier. Whoa, 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 whoa. Cole Phelps is gonna swing like the world is something, something, yeah. Something, something, yeah.
Deirdre Muller's missing watch.
Another stanza from this Shelley poem. We'll get to,
From the temples high of man's ear and eye, roofed over sculptures and posy. Where have I seen that?
From the murmurings of the unsealed springs. Oh, where science is something, something.
Jesus Christ, hold it off that goddamn thing.
Find a rope, Rusty!
There isn't time. See if you can swing that thing side to side. Get it over the edge, set it up for it. Swing!
Whew! Action sequence. That poor security guard is just like hanging out doing his shit, doing his shift. Like,
that was too close.
Yeah, well, the higher you climb, the further you fall.
Let's get out of here.
Another Dahlia clue?
No, a yellow gold wristwatch.
A Molder Dame.
Yes, and a scrap of the poem.
Another location.
If I can work it out.
Okay. This one. Oops. Hold on. Gotta go to the map. Can't believe I figured that out so quickly. Wow, what a brilliant detective I am.
KTI reminds you a great job awaits you in the United States Army. Enlist now.
He keeps mementos from all his victims.
This guy needs to be taken out of circulation.
He takes pleasure at stringing us along, demonstrating how much smarter he is.
You can enjoy it while it lasts. Got you now, genius. Coming for you.
Well, are we?
Iron you need for healthy blood and bones. That's why it's time to rise and shine.
Whoa. Looked at the map there for a second, and the guy's like, I'm sure to go ahead and come on over in this lane. You're clearly going faster than me. Don't worry. Whoops.
Just go easy, Phelps.
Shut up.
Position studies show 3 out of 4 women lack sufficient iron. If you are losing weight, feeling run down, weak, or easily upset, get the vigor and pep you need by using Rise and Shine yeast and by taking Rise and Shine yeast.
I feel like people would like notice. Like, there's a guy on like the roof of the library.
I'm hauling myself up there.
Go get him, Tiger. Hey, thanks. What's her name? Kirsten Dunst. Anyway, appreciate it. Oh my god, Cole. Jesus, dude. It's not even that far. Oh my god. He's gonna slip off, fall, and die from like a 4-foot drop. What a dramatic person. Alright, here we go. Platforming, this game's strong suit. When everyone thinks of L.A. Noire, they say, what was the best part about it? And you go, platforming. It was a lot of fun. Okay, thank you for the auto jump. Appreciate it. Oop. Ladder time. Ladder time. Alright. Here we go. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Sometimes a step backwards is a step in the right direction.
Thank God he did not do. Are you fucking serious? Oh my god. It's good that they put that piece of dialogue there, because otherwise everyone would have been like, fuck this. Found it. Hang on. Hold on. Nope. Yep. Hold on. Okay. So the LA Public Highway. Library. Alright, we got it. We got it.
Our Lady of Guadalupe. Ripped from Antonia's necklace.
Another excerpt.
Round which death laughed. Sepulchred emblems of dead destruction. Ruin within ruin. Treasure hunt.
The wrecks beside of many of city vast, whose population which the earth grew over, was mortal, but not human. See, they lie. Their monstrous works, their and uncouth skeletons, their statues, homes, and fanes, prodigious shapes huddled in gray annihilation, split, jammed in the hard black deep. That last part's like the key for. I think I got both of the clues. Whatever.
What is it this time? The religious medal from the Maldonado case. The Dahlia, Moeller, Maldonado. When this gets out,
we still have to find the guy, Rusty.
Another poem. Well, you must have some idea, right? Come on, Phelps. We're on a roll here. Don't let me down.
What do you mean we're on a roll? Oops. Hold on.
He's a cop.
Isn't that the cop?
I sure am a police officer. Thank you for noticing.
Look.
Alright. That's our car. We're gonna just test a couple of these.
It's a book.
Didn't have that one. That's okay. Nothing. It's okay. It's okay if there's nothing here. There's some. Oh, there's some cars over there. Oh boy. Damn. 0 for 3. Gamers need gamer food. Hot Pockets, baby! Okay.
We're gonna catch hell for this. Banging up innocent men.
The newspapers will banging crucify the guy. They won't have time to wonder about our mistakes. We'll be okay, Rusty. As long as we catch the guy.
I hope you're right, Cole.
God, you're gonna kill us!
Well...
I hope you're right, Cole. We'll be famous if we make this case.
All units in the vicinity in nearly Century Unit. 211 is shots fired. 410 South Flower Street. Units at Canano Code 3 identify.
Oh, that ambulance, that's one to get. That's one to get. I definitely don't have it, because I tried to, and then I accidentally started interviewing someone. Again, just Cole Phelps making noises while he's driving. He's like, shut the fuck up. I'm not drunk enough for this. Going here, game. Where are we going? What's over here?
I'm confessing that I love you. All over again.
Whoop, hold on. Whoa!
Whoa! I've always found the siren useful in situations like this.
Shut the fuck up.
It makes short work of dirt and cooking grime. Just the swish of the dish rag gets them sparkling.
Kind of dizzied myself there. My bad.
Wow, these pots sure are clean.
See? You will be whistling too without easy.
The elephant. What a weird thing to have.
Hey, Cole, let's get moving.
Russell Wilson said that he's never requested a trade. Interesting.
These are my best shoes, Phelps. I'll leave you to it.
Oh, I'm sure they're your best shoes. I'm sure you don't have very many good shoes anyway.
Very funny.
Whoa! Get a move on, all those boards are sinking. You want to end up like the other fossils? Gangway snakes around, Phelps. Can you see it through the car?
Steady.
What?
How you doing out there?
I'd be doing better if you were the one trying to get across this thing.
But that would be interesting gameplay.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Forefront of my thinking. Steady.
Is it on this island? Is this where I'm supposed to be going? Oh, it's right there. Hey, there's the other shoe.
one of Teresa Terrelson's shoes.
Yarp. And another poem.
A sphere which is as many thousand spheres. Okay, where to now?
And from the other opening in the wood rushes, with loud and whirlwind harmony, a sphere which is as many thousand spheres, solid as crystal, yet through all its mass flow, as through empty space, music and light. Obviously, we are going to the art museum. Duh. How could you not figure that out?
What is it? An open-toed white shoe and another stanza from the poem.
Oh, I really thought that hobo bum did the Terrelson broad.
Confessions from the insane aren't the most credible evidence, Rusty.
Is this thing over?
It's all part of his power over.
Sounds like a whiny little bitch. Run round is all this over?
So if we keep this up, we can find the guy?
Oh, okay. So now we go here, to here. Oh, fuck. So I think it's like a big maze or something. This is like the case that you really want to make sure you get 5 stars on the first time through, because it is not... It is not the most interesting of the cases. It works as like a final case of a desk, but it's like replaying and it's just god awful.
Well, this guy looks out for women in bars who've had too much to drink,
who are emotionally disturbed,
need a shoulder to cry on. He plies them with booze,
probably offers them a lift home,
then beats their brains out and strangles them. There'd be any schmo hanging out in a bar.
No, not anyone. He displays the bodies, leaves us messages. For all the violence, it's very controlled behavior.
The water just looks so bad in this game.
On it goes. Do you think we'll reach the end of this thing?
Okay. Here we go. Big maze.
You ever been in here, Galloway?
No. I have no intention of going in. I heard that thing's tricky. I want to wait here and have a quiet smoke. Think about hidden meanings.
Okay. Hold on. Definitely feel like we're moving in the wrong direction here. All right. Hold on. Ah, shit. That's a dead end. All right. Good. This is exactly what I wanted. Perfect. I think this is the way I came, maybe? So around this way. Go down here. Fuck. Oh, look at that, I did it. Oh, thank God. So I definitely was not looking at the instructions. was using the right stick. Definitely need to use the left stick. Whoa.
Once belonging to Celine Axford Henry.
Didn't take too long. Worked out all right.
Thrones, altars, judgment seats, and prisons. No, it couldn't be.
Wherein, and besides which, by wretched men were bore scepters, titans, swords, and chains, and chains and tomes of reason to wrong, glossed on by ignorance, were like those monstrous and barbaric shapes, the ghosts of no more remembered fame, which from their unworn obelisks look forth. Thank God you don't have to get out.
See? That was easy.
I found Celine Henry's ring.
How far does this thing go? How did we not catch this nut job?
Because he didn't want to be caught, Rusty. Also, the entire time you were like, but it's not them, it's not connected. Just get it out of your head, Phelps. There's no connection. This is your fault, Rusty, you stupid bitch. Get the fuck out of the way.
Isn't he the cop who won a medal?
He's the cop that made you shut your fucking mouth. Don't you ever talk to me like that, goddammit. It's weird that the excerpts and whatever. The important part is I have all of the clues. Just give me 5 stars on this case, and then we can be 15 gamer score richer.
He's leaving us this trail of evidence.
Why? Vanity. He wants to see if there's anyone out there smart enough to catch him.
He leaves us evidence, but every location is a trap.
He's testing us, physically and mentally, to see whether we are worthy of him.
The Titan guy, who had the stoush with God.
Very good. You thinking about reading some Shelley?
All that egghead stuff? I'm sticking to the funny papers and the form guy. You sleep better at night.
Hyenas, the citizen reports a 211 in progress at 9th and Grand.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's become a rainy afternoon here in Los Angeles. Whoa. That bastard ran a red light. Little fishtail there, no big deal. All right. I think I only had to play this case once. I think it's pretty difficult to not get 5 stars on this one. How do I get here? Oh, maybe you have to run through it with your car. Maybe? Hold on. Hold on. Come on, Rusty.
Watch it, Will.
Watch it. Big elephant. I don't even think I realized that. Big ol' elephant.
Throne up there.
Oh, it's all elephants. Whoa.
Jesus, now look what you did. Hang on, Paul. I'll get you off of it.
I don't know. I don't know what you're supposed to do there.
Jesus, now look what you did. Hang on, Paul. I'll get you off of there.
You gotta make it to the next platform. Get that thing as close as you can, then jump.
Am I going the correct... Why do people keep screeching their tires? Where am I going? The throne is down below us? Oh, am I taking this ladder? Oh, I am. Okay, there we go. Solved it! Doom doom. The typewriter key.
Typewriter ring. Evelyn Summers. Place he calls home. End of the line.
Remit the anguish of light, of that lighted stare. Close those wan lips and let that thorn wounded brow stream not with blood. It mingles with thy tears. Fix those tortured orbs in peace and death. So thy sick thrones shake not that crucifix. So those pale fingers play not with thy gore. Oh, horrible. Thy name I will not speak. It hath become a curse. I see the wise, the maid, the lofty, the milled. Mild, the mild, the mild, the lofty, and the just, whom thy slaves hate for being like to thee. Some hunted by foul lines from their heart's home, an early chosen, late lamented home. We're so close to catching him. The intolerance set wasn't destroyed enough when we were here previously.
The whole thing was going to come crashing down on him.
I thought so too. He murdered Evelyn Summers, Rusty. The last trophy was her ring.
You find another piece of the poem?
Yes. The last piece.
You sure, Cole?
Let's find out.
Decipher the seventh one. Ah, whatever could it be? By going to the map, we'll go over here.
You might see this as a cry for help.
God's sake, Phelps. I'm not trying to justify this.
Hear me out, Rusty. This guy has been successfully slaughtering women in this town for half a year. Maybe longer. He researches who he kills, and then plants evidence so that we always have someone to go after. If he hadn't sent the letters and the poem, he could have gone on forever. We would have been none the wiser. We would have four executed men on our conscience and have been happy about it. Why else is he doing this?
You're the new face of the department, Phelps. A modern cop tries to understand why the perp does what he does. Me? I just drop the hammer down on low lives. Crunch a roach under your heel, you don't worry about what it's feeling, you just grind it into the pavement.
KGPL to any unit. A citizen reports suspicious activity 111 South Alameda.
Nope.
Stand by for further.
Don't have time.
reminds me of my days as an altar boy.
There's a light coming from the house.
Nothing hasty, gentlemen. Keep your hands where I can see them, or I'll be forced to redecorate the stucco with your entrails.
We're from the LAPD, sir. I'm going to tell you only once to lower your weapon.
The LAPD, you say? Is it really possible you could have found me after all this time? How interesting.
Put down the gun, shitbird. Last warning.
This boorish ignoramus could never have found me. It was you, wasn't it? Do you remember me, detective?
The temp bartender.
Yes, you found me. You know what I'm capable of, and yet you walk in here like lambs dressed for the slaughter.
We'll see about that.
Garrett Mason.
Down the tunnel?
Can't let the son of a bitch get away.
The house, Rusty. There must be another entrance into the house.
Right this way.
LAPD, give yourself up.
Oh, there it is. Doom doom. When you're finished, when you're
this must have been the place, Rusty.
Okay, all right, Rusty. Jesus fucking Christ.
Jesus.
Just kick it in that door.
We're going down there.
I'll go. Call for backup and keep an eye out above ground and see where this thing comes out. Don't let me down, Rusty.
You're an interesting man, detective. Why the police force?
Ow.
Cease fire immediately.
Do I get a sense you're looking for personal redemption? Do you think we have something in common?
Nope. Yep. This one's the one you want there, buddy. Not the other one.
Surrender now, or I will use deadly force.
What the fuck are you talking about? I don't know where he went.
Are you comfortable out of the light, officer? Are you comfortable?
This thing has come to an end. You know that.
Where do you go? I'm really far behind you. Can you throw another gunshot or two so I know where the fuck I'm looking? Yep, that's obviously where I'd like you to go.
You're exactly what I expected. We were looking for a low achiever.
Am I going the fucking right way? I have no idea where this person is.
Reinforcements are on.
Oh shit. Found him. that actually, like, kind of startled me. Also, he's fucking invincible. So there's that. I fell so far behind him. Just running around that corner.
Where's the press, Cap? I think Phelps and I should get a medal for this. This has got to be the case of the year, right? The case of the century, when you think about it.
Are you finished?
Yes, Skipper.
Good. Because there won't be any press briefings or commendations.
What are you talking about? We got the werewolf, the guy who killed the Dahlia, killed all the other broads.
You got no one. Mason was a ghost.
Can you at least tell us why, Captain?
Mason is the half-brother of one of the most highly elected officials in this country.
How high?
Beyond the moon for mere mortals like us, Rusty. There'll be no more mention of him. The city owes you both, but there'll be no mileage in ever bringing this up again.
What's going to happen to the suspects in the cases, Captain? I won't be a part of that.
A bit of missing evidence at the grand jury. A procedural error here, a mistake there. All be quietly let go. The DA knows how we got to play it.
That's it?
I'm afraid it is. And I have some news for you, Phelps. No more rooting around in the entrails of cadavers and corpses for you. The head of vice has asked the chief for you. I'm reluctant to see you go to the glory boys of that vice, but my hands are tied. Go home to that lovely wife of yours. Celebrate your promotion.
Will I go see my wife? Probably not. Oh, thank God. The case of the Black Dahlia remains open, the truth lost to all but a handful of men. Well, there you go.
Breathe out, kid. You'll go purple. I'm scared, Sarge. Everybody's scared, kid. Anyone who says he isn't is a damn liar. How many times have you been in combat, Sarge?
I was with Raider Battalion on Peleliu my first time.
Was it bad?
It's always bad.
Will this be bad?
As bad as it gets, kid. But you stick by the Marine next to you, and he will stick by you.
So, some of the guys, they aren't very friendly, Sarge.
They've lost a lot of their friends in the last couple of days, kid. They think if they don't get to know you, that they won't have to grieve for you if you get killed. They're wrong. It doesn't work that way. Don't worry. No Marine in this company will let you down.
Ba-da-bum. All right. And that'll do it for part number four of this 102.39 miles. So a long way to go as far as the driving is concerned, but that'll take care of part number four here. We're done with the homicide desk, and we have, let's see, five in the vice desk, and six in the on the arson desk. I believe two on the vice desk are DLC cases, so we'll see a good bump in the achievements that we get on that one. And then get a bunch in the arson desk. So it'll probably be two or three in the next one, and then probably maybe two in the next one, and then three, and three. But there you go. 11 cases left. Four parts to go. Two, three, yeah. Four parts to go. hopefully you're enjoying this series. If you do like content like this, I'm having a good time revisiting this game. Now, I enjoy this game quite a lot. But if you are enjoying this revisit playthrough, there are three other parts that you can watch here on youtube.com/shontosaurusrex, and there are four more upcoming. The best way to be notified of when I am posting new videos is to subscribe by scrolling down and ringing that bell. You can also catch the live streams over on twitch.tv/shontosaurusrex, and I play this on Thursday afternoons with some baseball and random third other thing. I don't have like a necessary slot for it, or another game to go with it at the current moment, but that could change by the time we're all said and done here. Yeah, there you go. Hopefully you enjoyed this part. We will see you in another video. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.